I just said I finally can say I made money.
Oh, tell us, I love it. Success stories. I love it.
I bought it for nine. It was a five, almost 6 acres in Pennsylvania County, Virginia. Bought it for nine, sold it for 27.
How do you sleep at night? How dare you? Oh, God. 20, you wait a second. That's what, let's do the math. Somebody help me with the math. Is that $18,000 gross? A
That's
gross?
insane. Yeah.
And how much, and how did you give us the background? I'm sorry to interrupt, but I love, how did you find the property? How long did it take to consummate the deal, lock it up and remarket it?
It was a neutral offer. It was through a mailer. I just followed up with them about the first two calls were before I joined this, actually. 20, 15 minutes, calls. And then the last call was using the system, and I think it lasted about 7 minutes. And every time he asked me a question, I would just, hey, that's great. I think that's wonderful. You're so prepared. Like, and just kind of like stroke and nurture. And he just kind of at the end was like, yeah, let's do the deal. Because
Why?
I kept on saying, I kept on bringing up the emotion part of it, which was he needed to pay for their kid to go to college or something like that. And I was like, wow, that's incredible. Like, I remember when I went to school and it was a struggle. And when I had to have a part-time job, I don't want my son to have a part-time job. Well, let's do some business today and their whole first year can be paid for, right, sir? Yeah, absolutely. And then, the deal just kind of consummated and everything. So it worked out really well.
So I love two things you said. You used one of my favorite words today. Am I a little too pushy? You guys can tell me. I like the word today. Can you get me the contract today? Can we talk later today? Can you speak to your wife today? Can you know what happens? Is time our friend or our enemy in business, Freddie?
Enemy.
It can be our enemy. It can be also our friend. If we draw the line in the sand and set parameters, what happens when time, hey, this is great, Freddie. I want to do this deal with you, but I got to walk my five chihuahuas, and I'll get some, and I'll call you Wednesday or Thursday, buddy.
Oh, okay. Well, what's wrong with us talking today?
Oh, nothing. I'm just busy. My wife and I are going out for breakfast. I got to walk the dogs, and I got to ch change the toilet paper rolls and all in the bathrooms. And it's a busy, just busy life.
I hear exactly what you're saying, sir. But if I may and share a story with you, last week I went to breakfast with my wife. I made $18,000 on a deal. I told her at breakfast the whole week, beaming, completely happy. Isn't that something that you would want for your wife, when you're walking your dog and going to breakfast?
Imagine for a moment.
Sorry, that's my dog.
It's all right.
Imagine for a moment, you take her out to breakfast after walking the dog, doing all your chores, and you tell her, honey, guess what? I just made $20,000 extra on a phone call for 5 minutes with this guy. Imagine that, sir. How would that make you feel? How would that make your wife feel?
Can we do business now, today? Boom. Then go again for the, what do they call that? A pre-close or a trial close? You've got to get that commitment. You got to get that time frame today. Because by Thursday, he might find somebody else who will buy it from him, or someone will talk him out of it, or he'll forget about you or something else. So you got to go, that's the and prospects do that, don't they? Freddie, man, so did you got the contract right away?
Yeah.
And what did you do with it?
I sold it to an end buyer right away.
Wow.
We're going through, I think it's like a 30-day close or something like that.
Where
And
did you find the end buyer? Who was the end buyer? Where did they come from?
the end buyer, I found them on a tool. It's called Investor Base. I got that from Joe McCall. It's very helpful.
Can you put that in the chat room for us? Share it with us.
Absolutely.
Thank you. That'd be great. And so you called the, did you have to post it or call these people or email them or what did you do?
We listed it, but it was on there for a while because it was just not moving. But eventually, when I started doing this method, this kind of tool, it was just a lot faster. And speaking of more savvy folks that want a good deal, it just was a kind of a no-brainer for them. When I did remember to say today, you know, hey, I have a couple of people, I have more phone calls, like, so that really worked out.
There you go. So do you get some money down up front, or you got to wait for a 30-day escrow to get that $17,000?
It's all cash. So I said, hey, no problem. You know, and I did it that way because that person buys several deals in an area that isn't a lot of buyers. So I just said, it's okay. And we're going to do more deals anyway. I sent them a couple more. They're evaluating them. So it's a longer play.
You were rocking it. Round of applause for Freddie here. He's making money. I like to hear people making money.
And Claude, can I have a quick question on the previous role play?
Sure.
If somebody, like to Nitsin's example, right? Like, I don't know you. Is that when, like, for example, if we use Brent has a podcast. I'm assuming they have like YouTube, they have content, they have a website. Is that when you're like, great, no problem. And then you just kind of send them.